I want to thank everyone for coming down here to Daniel K. Inouye International Airport, named after our senior senator, an incredible man, who has done so, did so much for his hometown of Honolulu, but also the state of Hawaii and his country. And I'm so grateful to be standing here today with Governor David Ige to talk about our new mobile testing lab, bringing capacity beyond belief to the island of Oahu so more people can be tested for COVID-19. And this could not have happened without the cooperation and heavy lifting by Governor Ige and his folks out here at the airport, Fort Fujigami and West Yonemine. This real estate is not owned by the city and county of Honolulu. It is owned by the state of Hawaii. And we're here at their good graces with this mobile lab that's behind us. And it's here at the International Airport to assist people who are traveling inter-island and also people who work at the airport and also those who live in our community who can come here and get tested. Before I get into greater detail, I did want to ask Governor Ige to say some opening comments, and then we'll get into the meat of the coconut and then open up to questions. Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us here. I'm excited to be here at the blessing for this new facility. I wanted to thank Mayor Caldwell, the City and County of Honolulu, the National Kidney Foundation of Hawaii, and the consortium that really brought this laboratory facility here to the islands. You know, the Hawaii Pandemic Action Plan has three pillars. The first is protecting public health. Second is reviving our economy. And third is strengthening our community. And protecting public health has been the highest priority for all of us. This facility really focuses in on that, the ability to diagnose and identify those in our community that might be infected by the coronavirus is so important. And it's really important that we are able to not only take the sample, but process the sample here in the islands, because anytime we need to send a sample to the mainland, it means that we won't get a result back for 3 to 5 to as much as a week later. So having this lab facility here in the islands, being able to process the samples within 24 to 48 hours is a fundamental strategy and foundation upon which we build our public health program. So I just really wanted to congratulate all of those involved with bringing this facility online. It is an important part. As the mayor had said, it would facilitate inter-island travel. As you know, we do have a quarantine between islands, and being able to test here right at the airport for neighbor island residents returning to their islands would allow them to test out of the quarantine. I think most importantly, just this facility has the potential to double the testing capacity here within the state of the within the state of Hawaii, and that will make a tremendous difference for us in identifying those who are infected and controlling the virus here in the islands. So congratulations to all involved. I look forward to bringing this facility online. Most importantly, I do believe it'll make a tremendous difference for all of the people in Hawaii. Thank you.
Thank you, Governor Ige, again for working in cooperation with the City and County of Honolulu and allowing us to bring this mobile lab to your property here at the Daniel K. Inouye International Airport. So this state-of-the-art lab that stands behind me is brought to our attention by the National Kidney Foundation, who is working to protect the public of the United States, in this case, the public of the state of Hawaii. And this is a fully integrated lab system, fully integrated from beginning to end. It's end-to-end IT process, connecting all of the dots, from the initial registration to be tested, to the actual testing, to the results being given to the patient, to DOH, the Attorney General's Office, HPD. And it has all the components necessary to make sure it's followed medically correctly. It has even an ability to have enforced, enhanced quarantine enforcement programs through Data House, so we can download an app, and then if someone becomes positive, we can contact trace. And here's the thing. Being fully integrated, it means that we have capacity to test up to 10,000 people a day. That is 300,000 people a month. The entire state of Hawaii from the beginning of the pandemic in March till now is probably somewhere between 300 and 400,000 tests. And we can do that in 1 month. Now, the proof is in the pudding, and we're gonna put them through the proof part of it. Initially, it won't be 10. It'll probably be less, but we'll start and slowly gear up, but we have that capacity. And it's a PCR test, which is a gold standard with almost 100% accuracy. It's not some of those other tests which are 89% or 92%, almost 100% accurate. And through this process, the city and county of Honolulu has purchased already 42,000 test kits to make sure we have the ability to start testing. And that's a lot of tests to be done in short order. And the other thing that's different than any other lab, this lab is dedicated to just one thing, testing for COVID-19. The other on-island labs test for other things too, and that's why they can do the test results, the turnaround time, somewhere between 3 and 5, 6 hours. And initially, they're doing them right now a lot quicker. So you could be looking to travel inter-island, come here, get a test, wait for 3 hours or less and get your result and know you're not positive and you're on your way. And that's why it's so incredible to be here at the Daniel K. Inouye International Airport. And the other thing, this lab here can be turned into a vaccination center. So long after I'm gone as mayor, Governor Ige has the ability to turn this into a way to get people vaccinated maybe twice. And it is somewhat mobile. It could be moved to other areas at the right time to start to make sure that people are vaccinated up to about 70%, so we can put this COVID-19 behind us. So it's forward thinking and planning for the future. Now, we signed a letter of intent with the National Kidney Foundation on October 5th. On October 9th, General Hara, who I want to thank so much for him expediting this process, gave us the permission to locate the lab here out at the airport, working with Fort Fujigami and West Yonemine. And on November 1st, just 5 days ago, the first tests were being done, full operation up and running. And you can see the folks behind us who will start doing swabs. And I'm inviting everyone here today, everyone in this group, it's a large group, to go get tested. Why not get that added insurance that you're okay? I believe you all are, but you know, get that added insurance. So, as of right now, 85 people have been hired to help run this mobile lab, all local, and they're helping in many different ways. The medical director is Dr. Eugene Wong. The lab director is Dr. Alan Wu. We have Synergy Med here, Data House here, Capture, H2O Process Systems, and Kalihikai Urgent Care. The swabbing can happen here, but they also have the ability to do mobile labs, let's say at the inter-island part of the terminal, which is on the other side of where we're standing. So they could have a mobile lab stood up there. They have the test kits and capacity to do the swabbing while you're waiting to get processed through on the inter-island side of the terminal. The test will be done here, and you could get your results in 3 hours or, I believe, less right now. So the people who are hired are licensed lab technicians, swab team members, safety team members, compliance team members, and supply team members. And as was mentioned, all the lab testing is done here, so you don't have to go off to the continent. The other thing is all the supplies, the reagents, all dedicated supply streams, so we're not in jeopardy of running out of the supplies needed to do this testing. The other thing is, right now in Hawaii, we run somewhere between 2,500 and 5,000 tests per day. And you start to max out our lab capacity. Long term, the governor has funded expanding that capacity with our other local labs. so that more testing can be done. But until we hit that, this lab steps in. It helps providing that additional capacity to get more people tested, to keep us safer, but not maxing out our local lab capacity. Initially, as this lab opens up, we want to make it available to first responders and their families here in the city and county of Honolulu. And that could be first responders working for the city, but also first responders who work for the state and the federal government. And of course, island residents who want to come down here, park, get swabbed, and get your result in three hours. And of course, airport workers here at the airport, those who work for the state of Hawaii, those who work for the airline industry and the visitor industry here. And of course, inter-island travelers in need of a pretest. As you know, to go from Oahu to other counties, you need a pretest to get out of quarantine. We're on our way of getting approved as a trusted partner. I've been assured that it's in the queue and hopefully we'll be getting it shortly. So those who need a pretest to go home or to see their family during the next holiday season, let's say Thanksgiving, can come here, get a test, and before they get on the plane, know that they're negative and or they're on their way. And you can sign up or get more information on this lab by going to kidneyhi.org, kidneyhi.org, or oneoahu.org for more information. With that, we have a couple other people who want to have speak. The first one is Glenn Hayashida. He's in charge of the National Kidney Foundation of Hawaii. And again, we want to thank him for him stepping up and helping us. Glenn.
Thank you, Mayor. You know, when we had the meetings with the mayor and the governor, I was impressed with the fact of their commitment to what the governor said earlier, in a sense of, we want to protect the residents of Hawaii. And at the same time, the mayor did not want to take resources away from their community. And so with all of that, we tried to, the National Kidney Foundation, mobilize a team of experts, people who can address those problems. The ones that the mayor was talking about in terms of running out of tests, the governor talked about the test results being so, taking too long. And I think the governor actually said something about 24 to 48 hours. I just want to say that the test results can actually come back in 3 to 5 hours. So that will really address the needs of the passengers and the travelers. So with that, this lab is, what you see behind you is just a testing facility. We have the swabbers through Kalihi Kai, urgent care. We have Data House providing the back end information to all the governmental agencies. It's a very comprehensive solution to the problem. And we think it's going to help preserve the resources of the community, protect the residents, as well as from the passengers, because we all know we have to open up the economy. So I want to thank the governor. I want to thank the mayor for the support of this initiative. And as he said, we are trying to think ahead, not just today, but how are we going to address the needs of the future? So thank you very much.
I did leave out another group that we want to see if they can also have tests done out here, and that is visitors coming from Japan, which start tomorrow. And when they go home, they have to quarantine for 14 days. And I know the governor, maybe you can add some things to this, is working with the government of Japan to see if perhaps they would approve this lab so that people from Japan who want to come here really badly, love this place, all will be pre-tested in Japan. Every single one of them on the plane coming over will be pre-tested. And we know that from history, they wear face coverings even prior to the pandemic. They follow every rule and protocol that's required. They tend to spend more money in Hawaii, and they go home very appreciative of their experience. And we'd like them to go home without having to quarantine for 14 days. Perhaps because it's international travel, you usually have to arrive at the airport 3 hours before they could come here, get a test, a pre-travel test to go home to Japan, and be cleared. And so when they arrive in Japan, they can go about their business, use public transport, and not be impacted by the quarantine. But it does take effort, and I know the governor is working on that. But Governor, you want to add anything to that at this point, if you want to? Okay. I did want to mention that. The other thing for inter-island travel, we're, as I said, as soon as we get the trusted partner approval, and I know it's around the corner because we've been told by all the parties who have a say in it that it's coming anytime. The minute it's announced, this lab can then be used by those folks traveling inter-island to be tested. Next, we want to have Hilton Raithiel of the Hawaii Association of the Healthcare Association of Hawaii to say a few words. He's been at many of the press conferences with the governor. He has his finger on the pulse of our healthcare system. He's been watching every single day what's happening in terms of the number of cases and the impact on our healthcare system, from hospital beds to ICU beds to ventilators and everything else in between. We're really grateful that he's here. So would you like to say a few words? Thank you.
On behalf of our 170 healthcare member organizations on the, across the state, we'd like to thank the City and County of Honolulu and the Governor's Office and the Kidney Foundation and all the other partners on this incredible partnership and this expanded lab capacity, which is very important for our own residents and for all the visitors. And increasing visitors is a critical part of our island economy. So testing is a very, very good thing to have. It's great that we have this additional capacity. But as the mayor said, we are very concerned about what is going on. We know we have Thanksgiving coming up. We know we have Christmas. We know we have the New Year's celebrations coming up. And the numbers that we're seeing over the last few days do give us pause for concern. So testing is good, but prevention is better. And we're asking everyone to continue to focus on what the mayor and the governor have been asking us to do, which is to keep wearing our masks, keep maintaining our social distancing. During Thanksgiving, I mean, people love to get together, they want to get together, but we have to be very, very careful. COVID-19 is not a fun disease to get. A lot of people just get it and they shrug off the symptoms and they think they're fine, but we're just learning to understand, or beginning to understand, some of the long-term repercussions of COVID-19. So again, this is a great facility. This is very, very helpful for our state, for our visitors. It's a great partnership, a great collaboration, but let's keep all of ourselves and our communities and our visitors safe and healthy during this holiday season. Thank you.
I also think we have to say mahalo to Toby Solidum, who's right over here. He has had his hands all over this effort and has done so much to stand up this lab. He's totally committed, went way out on a limb in the early days of getting this put together. And I think without his push and effort, we wouldn't be standing here in the fifth day of November talking about this lab opening up and having a blessing. So a round of applause for Toby. Couple more things again, and you know, a thank you to Governor Ige and his team, particularly Fort Fujigami, West Yonamine. We want to make sure that visitors, as they arrive here and then go into Waikiki, that they know what all the requirements are in terms of face coverings and groups of more than five and 6 feet apart and all of those things in between. And so they've allowed us to hire Roberts Hawaii folks. Roberts is out here working at the airport inside the security gates. And we're going to be hiring people using our CARES money, about $300,000 from now until the end of the year, to distribute flyers. And I hold one here that we're having printed. This will be given to everyone disembarking on Oahu. And it reminds them of what they need to do to keep themselves safe, so they arrive safe, they stay safe, and they go home safe. And they practice their kuleana. We all do that, the visitors and the locals. We can live with COVID-19 and open up to visitors and be safe for everyone. So these will be handed out. And then we have a pocket size card. So maybe they don't want to carry the big one, but they can put the small one in their pocket in case they need a reminder. Now we're also looking to do this in Waikiki through an Aloha Ambassador type of program, which we're working on right now. But it's a way to educate people and avoid confusion. And again, I want to thank the state for allowing us to be at the airport working with them. And I think, like everything else, we get through this through our partnership. The last thing I want to say is about what Hilton talked about. And that's where we are. So right now we're in tier two. We'd like to go to tier three. And for a while it looked like we're on track to do exactly that. But as we saw yesterday, we had 125 cases, which is not a good thing. And here's our tiers. We want to get into tier three. And what's critical is today is the first day of the next 2-week period where we need to hit a certain number and a certain positivity rate to move into tier three. So from today going forward, it's critically important that every single one of us, starting with me and starting with all of you, that we do our part. Because right now, the 7-day average for the last week was 71 cases. We need to be at 49 cases or lower to go to tier three. We're at 71, so we're not there. We're about 30 too many. But I believe we can get there, but we got to drive this curve down now and work really hard. And you need to be at a positivity rate of 2.49 to go to tier three. And right now we're at 2.7. We can get there, it's not that much. But with the direction we're seeing today or yesterday, it is somewhat concerning. Now I'm hearing that the cases for Oahu for today are 66. That's better than 125. So it's gonna pull down that number, but it's still too high because we wanna be below 50. So that means tomorrow and the day after that, we need days where it's 30, even 20. If we can do that, we move into tier three. And why is that so important? We can then have 10 people over to our homes for Thanksgiving. And we can do more things and more businesses can open up in more ways. We want that. And we want visitors to keep coming here. If we're in tier three, visitors say, we already are one of the safest places in America in terms of prevalence, for sure. But we want to keep it that way. We don't want to go on the New York Times list for states that see surges. We want to remain in New York Times list for the 5 safest states in the country. And I believe we can do it. So let's work at this, starting today for the next 2 weeks. So we can say, we're into tier three, and I believe then we could even get into tier four before the end of the year. We have it within us. We do practice kuleana. We're one small place where we are 1 degree of separation from everyone else. So let's love our families, our larger families, the million people of this island, by being careful and not making any mistakes. With that, I think I covered everything, didn't I? Did, except we'll take some questions and then we're gonna open it up. Do the blessing first. Okay, good. And then we'll come back for questions. Okay. So before we turn over, Kahu Ke Koa, I was so happy when I saw him here. When he prays for us, he somehow picks up the mana of the aina and the heart of the people and tells stories. And while it's super hot and humid right now, I expect we're going to hear some very positive, uplifting messages from the Kahu. So thank you for being here, Kahu.
Aloha vakia kako, aloha. Well, you know, I've enjoyed what everyone has already shared with us, and I won't explain a little bit more about that, except to say one Oahu is one of our dreams, and this is a dream becoming a reality. And so what we really want to do today, as everyone who you have heard, is we want to be kako. We want to be together. And that's what it has taken for us to get to this moment, but it will continue with us moving forward. So we're going to use some of elements of our Hawaiian culture in doing this blessing today. There will be 5 of us that will be holding that mailele. For all of us, all of our hands do incredible work. And when we put our hands together, laulima, incredible things are able to happen. And so we'll use some of these elements of our Hawaiian culture in doing this blessing. So thank you everybody for doing your part, kako, oahu, so that we can move forward. I'll do some of the ole and chants from back there, and then we'll do our blessing. So, mahalo ke akua me ke aloha pumehana, e malama ho'o mai kapu he malumau. Ke akua, again, this aina is very important. This land is very important for where we travel to visit our families around the world But today it also becomes a very important place so that we can be together as ohana. We pule with much aloha. Amene no kia kua pau. Amene, amene, amene. Mahalo.
sorry, guys. I know how hot it is. I don't know why we didn't go over there. I have to speak for myself here. And if there's others for, like, the governor, if you could hold those or Glenn.
Okay. You can just address who your question is to, and we'll bring them over.
Yeah. But address them to me first. Yeah, to me first.
Yeah.
And then when you're pal with me, then you can go to the governor or Glenn Hayashida or Hilton Raphael.
I have questions for the governor.
And everyone else. Yeah,
he's in the lab right now, so.
Yeah.
Unless they want to, if they want to stand, it's fine.
Okay.
If they want to stand, us.
Yeah.
They're from America. They can handle the heat, the humidity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you want me to just go for Mario? Just go for it. Go, go, go. All right, Mayor, this question is from Manolo Morales, KHON2. AG Connor says the best way to enforce a mask mandate is to change the law so violators can be fined on the spot. Would you ask the legislature going into special session for this?
The short answer is yes, I would. You know, the Senate is coming back, I think, on November 18th to confirm the governor's judicial nominees and maybe other nominees. And it would be great if they came into special session and really rushed a way to address a big problem. You know, under our emergency proclamations and orders, the only choice the Honolulu Police Department has is to cite people under HRS Section 127A, which is a petty misdemeanor, meaning 1 year in jail and up to $5,000 in fine, and a jury trial. And we prefer, you know, maybe a ticketing system of, you know, $500, but no jury trial, not even showing up, just pay the fine. If that can happen quickly, that would take care of this problem. We're also looking at maybe trying to do it at the county level, but it's going to take a while because, you know, the hearing process. But I support what AG Connors has said, and I'm hoping that perhaps the legislature could look at coming into special session to deal with this important issue.
She's also said the mayors have to agree on one proposed mask mandate that's the same for all counties. Is that being done?
My understanding is that the mayors are working on this. Actually, the corporation councils for each of the counties is working also with the Attorney General's office to see if all the counties can come into one same mask mandate. We're all a little bit different. And if we can reach agreement on this, then we'd have each county would be the same, which means the state would be the same. And then the state, through Attorney General Connors, would adopt the same mandate statewide. So we just had the discussion yesterday. We talked again today to see if we can get agreement between all the mayors. Of course, there's different challenges and each island is different. So I can't commit we'll all agree to the same requirements, but I'm hopeful.
Mayor, maybe it's more for the governor, but I'm wondering, besides Japan, are there any other plans with other countries in regards to travel bubbles and the testing? Would that be also considered to passengers that are going home to the mainland?
So the question was, you know, we talked about Japan, and the question was, would we try to use the same system from other countries, for example, South Korea or New Zealand or Australia, which are all pretty safe places that have very strict requirements. If their governments were to allow people to travel from their countries to Hawaii, and I know the governor, who's not here at this very moment, has been talking with other countries as well to see if they would agree to allow people to travel here and get out of quarantine here if they get a pretest approved by the state of Hawaii. I support those efforts and I hope that they're fruitful. As far as people going back to the continent, there are very few states who require quarantine coming from Hawaii. I know that New York State now is requiring anyone coming into their state, driving in, is going to have to quarantine and get a test. So perhaps folks from New York, if we get approval from New York to accept this lab as a approved lab for them, then yeah, we'd like to see visitors from New York take advantage of it. Maybe we'll get more New York visitors.
And of course, but would you also consider it if these capacities were here to do this, even if it's not required by another state, to keep our visitors safe when they get home? The testing when people leave the state of Hawaii, even to the mainland, even if it's not required by their home state, would that be something the state of Hawaii could offer to make passengers feel at ease to come here and go home safely.
So the question is, even if it may not be required in other home states for visitors coming here, could they get a test here and know that when they go home they're not positive? Yes, this is open to whoever wants to come and get a test. We cannot mandate that they get such a test because our state doesn't require it. But because of our testing capacity of 10,000 tests a day, right now we'd have that capacity. If someone wants to know, hey, I'm not positive before I get on the plane to go home, potentially get my family infected, yes, they could avail themselves of the test. Thank you.
Mayor, Rose Bernardo with the Star Advertiser asks, how much money in federal CARES Act funds was used to build the mobile testing lab?
So the lab itself was about a little over $4 million. But the entire cost of it is much higher because, as I mentioned, we're buying test kits, we're paying for personnel. So the total amount comes to, let's look in here, approximately $16 million. And I think every penny is well worth it because opening up our economy to visitors, stimulating our businesses, we're talking about billions of dollars in revenue versus, you know, approximately $60 million spent in CARES money.
Yeah, so on that, Sandy Oshiro, HPR, just asks how the cost will be covered after the end of the year.
So one of the good things, and I don't know if, Glenn, you want to talk about it, but they're going to be charging for these tests long after the CARES money goes away, and it should be self-sustaining, but perhaps you could add more to that.
Yes, so what the city has been able to do is, through the CARES Act, is provide the funding for this entire operation. So when the mayor talks about the money that is under contract for this project, again, it's not just for the test, it's not just for the lab that you see behind here, but it's for the whole comprehensive solution that this team has been able to put together. So we are talking about the swabbing, we're talking about the testing, we're talking about the reporting, the connection to all the governmental agencies, and there's specialized apps for the traveler that were tied into the Safe Travel Act. All of that basically is what this project represents, is able to do. Now, as far as going forward, that is the plan. So we talked to the mayor that if once we get the Trusted Partner Act protection, that we will be able to charge. And then it would be self-sustaining so that we can carry this on through actually 2021. So that is the plan. So even though the funding spent through the CARES Act expires, we are carrying this forward to whenever we need to.
I do have one question. How much will a test cost once you folks start charging?
We're actually trying to put that together. It's right now it's about $125 is what the pricing is. Again, part of that is a business decision as we move forward, depending on volume, but the initial price will be $125.
This next question is for Mayor, from Sarah Madison.
By the way, I would invite, again, the members of the media today, before you leave, go get tested for free.
Yes.
And see how you're doing and see how the process works so you can report on it first person and get a peace of mind, because you guys are out more than I am every day. Also those who are doing signing, maybe they get tested also for free, because you're out everywhere I am and everywhere Governor Ige is. Okay.
Sarah Madison, KHON2, wants to ask if you know the cause of the triple-digit case count yesterday.
You know, I asked that question of the director of the Department of Health, and she called me and explained that it is clusters that we see in homes, people gathering more than five and not, they're not from the same household unit. But also yesterday, there were a number of tests done by the military that was put into our system. So it could have been a one-time blip, which I'm hopeful of. And today, with the numbers down around 60, perhaps it was a one-time blip. But that added to the jump yesterday. But we are seeing a slow trend upward. We don't want that. We want to see a slow trend downward.
First of all, thank you very much for your big effort for Japanese tourists. I really appreciate it. Because of you, they will be able to come over to here from tomorrow. So they have actually two big issues still, because one thing is a really super expensive test, actually over 600. And one more is, you mentioned it, 14 days guarantee when they go back to Japan. However, in the future, they might be able to solve to those issues, right?
So the question comes from Keizu, and we want to thank them for always working with our Japanese American community here, our Japanese speakers. You do so much, not just during the pandemic, but during natural disasters. We couldn't do it without your voice. The question was, again, she was thanking me as mayor for inviting Japanese visitors back. That thanks goes to Governor Ike, not to me. All of it, 100%, he did it all. We're the beneficiary on Oahu because most Japanese visitors come here. And I think you should add to the question, but it was mentioned that the test that the Japanese visitor has to take in Japan costs approximately $600 US, as opposed to, you heard, $125 here. And so it's a steep price to come here, and they gotta also buy their ticket. And then the second part is that when they go home, they have to quarantine for 14 days. So again, if the government of Japan approved this lab and they got a second test for a lot less, they get out of quarantine, which I think would mean more people would come, because people have to go back to work when they return home, and they gotta go back and do other things. But Governor, would you like to add, because this is all what you did, and I don't know, Eric's here.
We do continue to work with the Japanese government to make it easier for the travelers from Japan to be able to come here and return without being placed into quarantine. But as you know, right now, the U.S. is closed to travel from Japan. As you know, we've had a record number of cases within the United States, and that's what's led Japan to place the United States in a different status. So we're working with the government so that we can recognize Hawaii separately from the rest of the states, and hopefully be able to get travelers who come to Hawaii to be able to get tested and return to Japan without quarantine.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Anything else? That's it. Thank you so much.
Governor, I have a question for the governor.
Oh, governor.
Please. So what's the progress on that, getting Hawaii residents into Japan? You're working with the government, but weren't we in their bubble before?
I think part of the challenge is we're in the middle of a presidential election, and obviously the relationship between Japan and the United States is the most important relationship here in the Pacific specifically. So, you know, we continue to be patient. The Japanese government is being thoughtful about how they look at the relationship between Japan and the United States. And obviously, we're expressing the notion that we are geographically isolated, and because of our quarantine, that it's not easy to travel from the rest of the United States to Hawaii, in addition to traveling from Hawaii to Japan.
With visitors continuing to arrive from the continent, there seems to be some confusion among some visitors on those trusted partners. Some people still come in without the trusted partners. What kind of additional messaging do you think the states needs to give out to people outside of Hawaii?
Yeah, so the question was that there seems to be some confusion about trusted partners for those coming in from Trans-Pacific. You know, we continue to work to expand the number of trusted partners. We do know that many want to travel to the islands, and we want them to be able to get tested prior to coming here. We are in the process of expanding that. I just came off of a video conference with all of our airline partners and talked about the partnership, getting the information out to all the customers, trying to re-emphasize. We want them to be aware that we do have a mandate for mask wearing here, which is separate from the quarantine itself. We encourage them to participate in the pre-travel testing program. We would rather they get tested and get a negative result prior to coming to the islands rather than coming here to quarantine. And we continue to build the most robust network of partners, trusted partners, that we can, so that those who want to travel to the islands can get tested 72 hours prior to coming to the island, so that we can feel confident that they are virus-free at that time.